on Kolkata's Elgin Road, right next to one of the busiest malls in the city, is an aristocratic bungalow that belongs to another era. For a casual visitor, there is nothing greatly unusual about this gracious home. But for hundreds of people, every day, this is no ordinary house. It is a house of hope.
আমাদের কাছে উনি সবসময় ভগবান। উনি যা করেছে আমরা মানে বলে বোঝাতে পারবো না।
ওষুধ খেয়ে যাচ্ছি, এখন খুব সুস্থ আছি, এখন আমি যাওয়া আসা করছি, সুন্দরভাবে যাওয়া আসা করছি, ভালোভাবে যাওয়া আসা করছি।
For patients and the medical fraternity, Dr. Prashant Banerjee is no ordinary doctor. The third generation homeopath from the family of Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar has pioneered the Banerjee protocols, a unique method of treatment which is swiftly gaining acceptance across the United States and Europe for its capacity to combat diseases, particularly cancer. The Banerjee's romance with homeopathy dates back a full 150 years. In the early 1860s, Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar became interested in the subject when the noted homeopath Rajen Dotto relieved his migraine. This prompted him to encourage his youngest brother, Ishan Chandra Bandyopadhyay, to take up the practice of homeopathy for the benefit of the poor villagers of their native village, Bir Singho. The year was 1865. It is Ishan Chandra's younger son, Poreshnath, who is credited with popularizing homeopathy across Bengal. Poreshnath gained early fame and wealth with the discovery of a snake bite antidote, Lexan, which gained worldwide popularity. This success enabled him to settle in Mihijam in Bihar, now Jharkhand, where he treated patients for free.
My father was an idealistic and patriotic person who early in his career turned down the opportunity to be a district magistrate by the then British government. He preferred to live among the ordinary Indians, and he learned homeopathy to give relief to the millions of poor people of our country. He not only treated the patients free, but also used to serve meals to the poor patients. From the very childhood, we could realize that it is our duty to use our knowledge and wealth for the benefit of the people.
As trainloads of patients began to disembark in Mihijam, Poreshnath discovered that in 80% of the cases, disease-specific treatment was as effective as holistic individual treatment demanded by classical homeopathy. In other words, if the doctor diagnosed the patient was suffering from typhoid, he could simply prescribe a medicine for typhoid instead of going through the classical routine of analyzing each of the patient's full range of symptoms to arrive at a prescription, which took a great deal of time. This approach was therefore similar to that of a conventional modern doctor and far removed from Hanuman's method.
It was my father who actually developed the protocols and spent a whole lifetime trying to convince the modern medical and scientific establishment about the effectiveness of this system. And this, the Banerjee protocols, as we have been coined to be.
Dr. Prashanto, son of Poreshnath, started learning homeopathic practice by assisting his father, and in 1960 moved to Kolkata to start his own practice. A scholar as well as a practitioner, he devoted his considerable energies to devising specific medicines for specific diseases, as in conventional medicine. With experience, he also realized that specific potencies and dosage patterns could be determined to design standard protocols.
Around the mid-70s, my father realized that the protocols he had created could have far-reaching potential for treatment. That is when he decided that we needed to reach out to the whole world and to popularize this system of the Banerjee protocols.
Conventional medicine has always been skeptical of homeopathy. For many years, Prashanto struggled against the disbelieving attitudes as he presented his cases, methods and successes to audiences across the world with presentations and papers. His persistent efforts paid off as the Western medical community began to realize that the Banerjee protocols were not only different from classical homeopathy, but also answered many of their objections against the classical system.
One of the major breakthroughs that happened was in the year 1996. That is the year that the National Cancer Institute, which is part of the American National Institutes of Health, which is the Ministry of Health, they invited us to submit some cancer cases which had been treated by us for their best case series program. We did this in the year 1996. So it took them 2 years to scrutinize these cases, and they invited us to present them before the Cancer Advisory Panel for Complementary and Alternative Medicines. We did this in the year 1996, July, and this panel actually comprises of senior researchers, doctors from the leading institutions of America. They listened to our presentation for 6 hours and thereafter accepted the presentation unanimously.
Recognition in America was a great victory for Banerjee protocols. Since then, the Dr. Prashanto Banerjee Homeopathic Research Foundation, the PBHRF, has been invited to join a number of collaborative efforts with American institutions for cancer studies. Many distinguished scientists from America and elsewhere have visited India to study the protocols and case records.
We have more than 36,000 cancer cases recorded digitally. We also have our own proprietary software, and our database and documentation of patients is something we are particularly proud of. We have around 36,000 cancer patients, cancer cases, recorded cancer cases, and 64 different cancers, including renal failures. We have many researchers and scientists from all over the world who come and they have a look at this data.
Many of these records go back 20 years and meticulously document case histories that build conviction. They also help to teach the new generation of homeopaths how the protocols can be practiced.
There's no such large clinic all over the world, and we are very grateful to be able to use the information coming from this clinic and to get insight in the data and to get insight in how to use these protocols and how to use the fixed potencies.
For homeopaths, the Banerjee protocols also offer another great advantage. Whereas classical homeopathy requires spending hours with the patient in order to gain holistic insight into his state of health, the Banerjee protocols, being disease-specific, require only a tenth of the time. This means the doctor can earn a reasonable remuneration without charging exorbitant fees.
Made more effective, more easy to apply by the Banerjee protocols, which is a huge contribution to the whole benefit, to the whole well-being of mankind.
The simplicity and economic viability of the Banerjee protocols make it ideal for rural health programs. Not only is it effective, safe, and economical for the patient, it also makes homeopathy simpler and more remunerative for the rural doctor, making it a win-win solution. Today, over hundreds of homeopaths across the world follow the Banerjee protocols, ranging from India to Spain and America. A story that began in a small Bengal village 150 years ago is spreading across the world.